Just the energy sector alone is scheduled to receive more than $3 billion in investment, and that is by no means the whole amount that is flowing into investment. This is a good thing, and it ought to be, but be warned, it must be taken with a pinch of salt.
The question is, for a country that has been receiving maybe $800 million, $1 billion in investments, are we ready to start receiving $3 billion of investments? Look at the demand for resources and the likely increase in prices for those resources, whether you are talking about labor, that the price of energy is likely to go up.
To add flesh to that, the argument is that with the limited skilled labor available, competition for them will drive up salaries and labor will move where it's paid highly, affecting smaller companies. And so, it will be the same for power, and the list goes on.
We have relatively high wages because of the high cost of food and housing in urban areas, which pushes up the cost of wages. The ports, the railways, the highways, the waterways are all woefully inadequate because suddenly we're getting growth, but the infrastructure has not been planned for that growth.
So, the little needed resources for which the investment will increase demand will endanger smaller companies and raise cost of operation in the economy. It could lead to the rise for the fittest, so to speak, unless something starts to be done now. Samuel Setumba, NTV, Business.